Hey guys, I have another zone cleaning routine for you. This week I am doing, or on this day, but in this week's video I am doing zone 2, so stay tuned for that. If you're new to my channel, my name is Michelle, and this is my everyday wife life. And don't forget to comment below and subscribe if you're new, and like and share. Okay, if you missed last week's video, you might want to go watch Zone 1 that I posted last week. So on Wednesday here, I am doing Zone 2. So first, I need to just do my daily chores in the bedroom and in the bathroom. But Zone 2 is pool, bath, dining room, entryway, library, and a laundry room. So yeah, here is the bathroom that actually is supposed to be in zone 1, but I moved it into zone 2 because I didn't finish it last time. I may permanently do it. So yeah, I'm not going to clean the shower. I use this little brush here to clean the shower that has a mixture of vinegar and Dawn in it. And I've seen many people use it on YouTube, and I don't actually like it too much because guess what? You got to refill that dang thing every time. So I'm going to get a spray bottle and put that in there. And there's laundry in here, and everything needs to be cleaned up and picked up and put away, which is a major part of cleaning, isn't it? So I do plan on washing the curtains because in the last video, I did the curtains in the bedroom. So I want to stay with that theme and do the curtains throughout the whole house, but just in zone 2 today. Just for right now, the craft room is not in any zone right now. It may be a zone all by itself in the future. We'll see. Anyway. A zone 2 is pretty easy. It is not I don't know, how do you want to say? We don't majorly use this area too much. Hubby was using it as his office, but guess what? He's retired now. So this video was actually filmed in May. So I told you that last time for zone 1. So, but I didn't want to waste the footage and wanted to encourage you to maybe revamp your zone cleaning if you needed to for one. So this is the process of me redoing this, trying to figure out what things I want to change about it. Staircase always needs cleaned up, and hubby, that is hubby's job. So I'm just showing you the state of zone 2 right now. So it's really not that bad in this video anyway. So I just have a little bit of pickup and put it away. But before I get started, I'm gonna go ahead and take the curtains down and get them washed so I can hang them up back up before the end of this video. So the curtains are what I'm calling deep cleaning. So that is part of my deep cleaning, spring cleaning, but it's summer, almost fall now. So there's that. But in this video, it was summer. And that was my plan, to do deep cleaning during the summer, not in the spring. I don't know why anybody does it in the spring. Spring is the most beautiful time of the year, even in Florida. So why would you want to spring clean? Why would you want to do that? Do it in the wintertime. Or in the summer when it's too hot if you live in Florida. Rue. This is not a ride. Get off my curtain. Stop. Oh, now they both think this is a ride. Okay. Okay, let's get the curtains back in or into the washer machine. I don't know. Those cats are silly. In fact, I didn't even put that curtain back up in the library because they apparently really liked it and are using it on the cat bed. This is several months later. It is now September. It has not been hung back up. Oh, well, yes, life with cats. That's what this is, life with cats. Okay, I am doing pick up and put away in this zone that is part of daily chores. So there is that. So also too, the craft room, back to that. Yes, I'm a nonconformist. Anyway, we talked about that in another video. So I am going to do the craft room and the garage starting hopefully in October. So you might be seeing those videos. Getting back to that. So I'm pulling down the curtains in the dining room so I can wash those. Okay, so I managed to get out my cleaning cart right away, unlike the last time. So if you want to know what is in my cleaning cart, inquiring minds want to know, I will have it listed down below in the description, everything that is in my cleaning cart, although it changes from time to time. So I am doing a deep cleaning of the bathroom. I don't do everything, like I don't do the shower, because I do that while I'm taking a shower and nobody wants to see that. Anyway, so I am using my handy dandy Lipman duster thing as a cleaner. It just makes things easier. Isn't that O-Cedar? O-Cedar makes life easier. Yeah, it's not O-Cedar, it's Lipman. This is cleaning the sink and the toilet. Obviously, that is a weekly chore, but I will soon get to doing the floor and the tiles on the wall, which has been forever. But I am doing something called Korean bathroom clean on the floor, and I saw that from Live It Like. Lisa, if you want to see her video and see what I was talking about, I will link that down below. And if you go to her channel, let her know I sent you by, and oh my, the dust on the top of the tile wall. It may have been a year or two since that's been done. So let's get it done now. And I use the pool bath as my bathroom because I don't like taking a shower in our bathroom. Kind of like having my own bathroom too. I might need a cabinet above the toilet. But anyway, we have a big open shower and I really don't like that. I like the small enclosed shower. So I had moved over into that shower. Well, since Sun been here, but I used to use the guest bathroom as my bathroom. But now that's his bathroom, yada, yada, yada. Now I am dusting all the things. Everything is really dusty in here. I don't know, you know, dusting the pictures on the wall and stuff was like the last thing that needed to be done when you're down and out. Okay, I am just taking all the towels done off of the towel rack in there. It's not where I hang my towel. I hang my towel on the glass box wall with a command hook. So those are purely decorative. Yes, I have decorative towels. But they haven't been washed in a while. They're for guests, but I never have guests. So anyway, so I'm throwing those in the wash and cleaning up some more dust. I really should take the picture down, but I don't. I will do that in another video and clean that more thoroughly. Just getting all the dust again off the top of the tile wall. Super dusty. Okay, so that Lipman dusting wand, we're just going to call it a cleaning wand, microfiber wand, works really well for cleaning behind the toilet, and you don't have to reach your hand down in there. Look at how dusty the toilet brush is. And I used to have the metal toilet brushes so they would look nicer, I guess. No. I just started buying the plastic ones and replacing all the ones in all the bathrooms. We have 4 bathrooms. And because they were getting all rusty. So buy the plastic ones. Do your favor and buy the plastic ones, even though they're not decorative. What was I thinking? Okay, so I'm getting ready to mop the floor. I guess I just Windexed the outside of the shower door and the pool bath door there. But I'm rehanging a command hook so I can hang my towel back up. It was kept falling off. I think it finally sticks this time. I do not clean the glass box this time. I will do that next month. That would be a monthly chore. And, you know, there's weekly chores, daily chores, monthly chores, seasonal chores. Who wants to keep track of all that? I just clean it whenever I feel I need to. So in the mop water is Dawn and vinegar, and it's super soapy, even though you can't really see that in this video. But I am being a little more careful because when I did the bathroom, my master bathroom, which I didn't film that, that was on the fly. I did it by myself one day, watched Lisa's video, and then I'm like, yeah. But I have my mop slippers on because you want to be careful if you want doing this. So the idea is to get it super soapy and do a real thorough clean. And guess what? It really did get it super clean, and it has stayed cleaned since then. So I haven't really needed to mop with the Ocedure Makes Life Easier mop since then. I just do it with my Ocedure spray mop, quick mop thing that I've shown in videos. That just works better. The whole mop bucket thing, I mean, I do really like this Ocedure mop, but the mop bucket ends up being just sitting around thinking I'm gonna finish the rest of the house, and then I never finish the rest of the house, and then yeah, anyway, whatever. So I am doing a really thorough job of cleaning it with the soapy water, but I do end up needing, because it's so soapy, which again, I don't understand why that's not coming off in this video. Just be careful you don't add too much soap. I did that when I did the master bathroom, and just get it super sudsy and clean everything all up, and then I had to rinse it with some clean water and a new mop head, which I think I have like 4 or 5. Those things you can just throw in the washing machine. So awesome. Anyway, so I'm just going to finish up mopping all the tile walls and the floor, and I do end up using the mop to clean the front and back of the door too while I'm at it. So just like any video, any products I mention in this video will be linked down in the description. I am an Amazon affiliate. I make pennies, honestly, people. I make pennies. So, but you know, the links are there for you. And also am a Magic Links affiliate. So that would be for Target, things like Target. So I do like to buy some things from Target. Maybe you do. You get free shipping to your house, to your door, and it doesn't cost you extra like it does on Instacart or something. It is straight from Target. So the links for those will be down below in the description. Okay, so not super satisfying like I've seen in some videos. I'm like, did you put a handful of dirt in there? Because my floors are not that dirty. And I promise you, they do not get mopped that often. And that water was not that dirty. But I'm going to go ahead and do a rinse here. So, yeah, because the floor was quite soapy, even though you couldn't tell. Okay, so I am contemplating getting a cabinet above the toilet. I do have this toilet paper roll holder, but Rue likes to shred paper, so I can't store the toilet paper in there because it will get all shredded. So I need some place for that, and some place for like my shampoo and conditioner and extra backups somewhere, because my shower is filled up with all the extra stuff. Anyway, just a few things that I use in this bathroom. Since it's my bathroom now, I want to put in the cabinet. Still contemplating what I want there. I'm not sure. Might have my brother-in-law make me something. He's really good at that. He made the cornices that are above the windows in the family room. If you are a lister like me, although here lately I like to write it in my planner, handwrite it, get it out of my head, down on paper, but you might be interested in this free printable. It just shows you everything, being like a Sunday home refresh, your daily chores for each day, and then what you will be doing in your zone cleaning each day. So that Free printable will be listed down below in the description, along with a bunch of other free printables that might interest you. Putting the bathroom back together and just doing a quick check of thinking of things that need to be done in the future for Fix Up Friday, like that light needs to be changed out to a white light. Yeah, and now I am going in the laundry room and starting a new load of wash and drying the curtains. Or no, I actually just hang the curtains back up and let them hang dry. That is the best thing to do with curtains. These are like more sheer like curtains. So I would recommend that. I wouldn't recommend drying those. Thank you. I'm just making my way through zone two and picking up and putting away where needed. And I got an Amazon package of notebooks and I did it again. Oopsie again. Didn't read the description. And the notebook that I got is not the size that I wanted. It's too small. Anyway, I'm not a take it back or so. I'm sure I will use that for something. I need the big tall ladder and maybe somebody's help to hang this back up. But in the meantime, I'll just lay it here and then this is what happens. And guess what? It's been there ever since. That was in May. It is now September. They love that thing. I don't know. Cats rule around here, apparently. The cat toys are out of control in this house. They have several baskets and my son ordered a new package. Really need to get rid of the old ones when we get a new package, but so far that has not been happening. It's on the to-do list. So because some of them are filled with the, what's it called, catnip, and you know it wears off after a while, but the old is mixed with the new and I don't know which is which anyway. So I have this empty basket and I'm going to go ahead and put the new cat toys in there and put it in the library for them to play with. That is really more like the cat playground right now. It has a few cat things in there, although they do spend a lot of time out on the pool patio now. So just cleaning up all the cat toys so that I can vacuum. So now I'm just cleaning up the dining room table. Hubby has went somewhere, I don't know, in the bedroom or upstairs. So it gives me a chance to clean this up, but I don't have to do that anymore. So if you missed that video, Hubby has retired. And I also was able to go ahead and clean and deep clean and decorate the dining room table for fall. If you want to see that video, it'll be listed down below in the description. Now I'm just going to do a quick vacuum of the zone 2 area that is part of weekly chores. So that does get done, but I also do mopping and I'll have to say that that is, should be a weekly chore. But in this area, it doesn't, the top floor doesn't really get too bad, but since I already have the mop out, I'm going to go ahead and do that. Maybe I will just use the spray mop that I talked about. on the other weeks. Yeah, maybe just, yeah, do the same as in the bathroom. Just use the Ociter spin mop once a month, and then just get the other mop out real quick. It's just so easy to just take out of the closet and not have to fill up a mop bucket that stands there for 3 days and starts smelling bad. Yeah, there's that. I apologize for the like jerkiness of this portion of the video. I time-lapsed this and recorded it in time-lapse, but for some reason on my camera, the time-lapse for straight time-lapse, filming in time-lapse, is like super duper fast. So if I try to slow it down, it gets a little jerky. So I have to remember to just record it regular and then edit it and make it faster that way. Anyway, it is what it is. I'm just doing a quick clean and straightening up of my cleaning cart. Hey, I maybe should show that to you in full on a Tiny Tidy Tuesday. Whenever my cleaning cart gets messed up again, I could straighten it up for you and show everything that is in there. Maybe you might be interested in that. I really like this, although I had got away from using the cleaning cart, but it's easy just to drag it out and around with me for throughout the whole house instead of having everything that I need in different places and grabbing it. Anyway, you get the idea. Anyway, it's time to take a break. It is 1:15 now. Definitely time to take a break. I must have taken a break earlier and not recorded. I don't know. Or maybe I had more energy back in May than I do now, although it is starting to increase since I started doing self-care September. So stay tuned for a live video on this Saturday and talk about what I did this week, how you're doing, checking in, and I definitely am gaining some energy from exercising and eating healthy. Okay, I'm just taking another break because I just finished up my daily chores in this section of the house, which would be straighten up and do the dishes. So I am working in my planner and checking off everything that is on my list. The notebook is working really well right now. At one time the checklists were working good, but maybe they will work for you if you're interested. Again, they're in the description below, bunch of free printables, or maybe use them as a guideline to start making your own list, because you know I'm a nonconformist. I do pull a few things from other people that I have seen, and I just learned how I worked naturally first throughout the house, and noticed I had a little pattern, although that has changed since then. You know, you got to change things up. If it's not working for you, stop trying to make it work for you. You know, that saying, like I said in the last video, stop trying to do the same thing, expecting different results. So I am changing things up and doing things a little bit differently. Like, I don't think I can do my deep cleaning on Monday, Wednesday, Friday with my zone cleaning. It's going to be separate here and there whenever I can fit it in. It's just too much for me. So there's that. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and stay tuned to next week. It will be zone 3. If you're new to my channel, click my face right there and subscribe. Until next time, guys, enjoy your day.